And welcome back to a new video. Today I have with me Dacia Duster 2. This is the 1.3 liter petrol engine, four-wheel drive, celebration version. And in this video, I will do the full review, interior, exterior. I also have on my channel the test drive with this Dacia Duster. If you want to see it, just check it out on the channel. If it's not already there, click the subscribe button to see the notification when the video with the test drive, Duster test drive, will come on my channel. But in this video, it's all about review. I will show you the space, I will show you the quality materials, interior, exterior. We will talk about everything, technical detail and all that stuff. Also guys, if you're new on my channel, just click the subscribe button to see all the new cars that come on the market today. And yeah, let's start with the technical details of the car. To be honest guys, this is one of the most, I mean, this is the most affordable SUV on the market today, and it's incredible, it's insane, this car. I mean, I see some video online on YouTube with this car off-road, and I was like, wow, what this car can do off-road, it's incredible at the price. I mean, it has a great price. So let's start with technical detail first time. This is the Dacia Duster 1.3 liter TCI celebration four-wheel drive. It comes with 150 horsepower, 250 newton meters, with a manual gearbox with 6-speed. This is great for getting some great consumption. I mean, this car come with 7.6 liter. This is kind of average consumption, but I know you can get some great consumption out of it with this manual gearbox with 6-speed. The basis price, it's 23,190 francs here in Switzerland, the basis price, the starting price. And it comes with all these options. We will talk about every single option in this video. Then if you want some extra, for example the spare tire or the color, metallic color, you can pay extra. Then this is the final price. And here at Galliker guys in Switzerland, in Bern, if you are around here, I will leave the link in the description so you can check them out. You have some 600 discount, so the price will be 23,240 francs. It's not a brand new car, it has 5,000 kilometer, but I think the final price should be there, maybe 1,000, 2,000 more. I will leave the price in dollars so you can make an idea. 165 CO2, 7.3 consumption, 1470 kilograms. So those are the technical details. Of course, we will talk a little bit more about the others that you didn't see it yet. And this car can do 0 to 100 in around 10 seconds. Yeah, it's not about that, because it's more about practicality. And yeah, anyway, let's go around the car to talk a little bit the design. Probably already see it. It has a nice design, interesting, not bad, not the best design on the market, but I think the car is made more for the practicality. Look at the ground clearance, look at the plastics around the edges of the car down there, look at the front of the car, the bumper, the way they design it. It's made special for off-roads, for bad roads. And this car off-road, it's a beast, it's a little beast. I love it. And also the rims, I think they fit perfectly with the car. I don't know about you guys, but the rims look just gorgeous. Now let's start with the lights in the back here. And as you can see, probably here we have normal bulb light for turning signals and also for daylight. I'm really curious to see the next version of the Duster. Probably they will come with LED lights. Probably it will look much better. It's not bad, the idea, the cross idea, but yeah, I want to see it LED in the future. I want to see how it looks in the LED version. Now going down here, you have normal bulb light on the number plate. Then you have a reverse camera. You will see that the car have 360 degrees reverse camera. I will show you a little bit later. So you have the camera here on the reverse. That's great to have it on the car as a standard, I should say. Going forward, guys, let me go on the side. Here are the mirrors. On the mirrors right here, big mirrors. You have a great visibility from the interior. Also, you have blind spot technology right here in the corner. I'm not sure if you can see it so well, but it's there. That's another great feature, safety feature to have it on the car. Then you have the camera down here under the mirror for 360 degrees camera. I will show you later when we go inside the car. Then you have the blinkers here on the body of the car. Also, you have four-wheel drive, so you know this version, it's a four-wheel drive. Going in the front, also in the front, I wish to see more LEDs from the lights in the front. So for example, the low beam, the high beam, it's normal bulb light. Even the turning signals, normal bulb light. Only the daylight running, it's LED light. You can see it on the side here. But other than that, I'm really curious to see the next version, the way the car it will look in the future. Overall, it's not bad. The design, it's nice. It looks quite nice. Going forward, down here on the bumper, we have also the fog lamps, also normal bulb light. So no LED. If you look closely right here on the down part, you can see you have kind of a grill here where you go the air inside and then to cool down the different parts right there. But I like very much this shape of the front of the car right here. It allows you to go off-roads without any problems. So the ground clearance is pretty high. The grille, pretty simple, some kind of chrome design here. Then you have the Dacia logo, and under the Dacia logo you have the camera for the front camera. And overall, pretty nice, simple. The hood, it's nice as well. It has nice lines and design right there on the hood. Sensors in the front, if I'm not wrong, you have one here for the blind spot technology. And then where are the others? I don't think you have parking sensors in the front. Yes, no parking sensors in the front. It has only those sensors on the side for the blind spot technology. In the back, it has for sure. I see it before. I like also the fact that they add this plastic. You can see this part, plastic part, come down here until here, because in this area, usually a lot of rust occur in time, and this plastic protect the edges of the car from rust, from stones, from all kind of stuff, and all that plastic go all over the car until on the back there. So super practical. I like that. I really like that. Going forward, also in the back here, it goes this plastic until here. That's nice. And also here, it begins with this plastic that protect this area, this paint here in the back. So that's really nice, really practical. I like that. Going in the back here, you have the fog lamp. Down here, this time you have the sensors for the blind spot technology, and you have also parking sensors, four parking sensors in the back. Pretty awesome. Here is the fog lamp, and then you have the exhaust pipe right here, and then you have this kind of a gray silver color in the back in plastic, and then you have matte plastic, kind of a air diffuser down here. But really simple, really nice, clean and nice. I like it. I like the way it looks. Upper here you have Duster writing letters, then you have the Dacia logo, and then you have this big window, tinted window here, and inside the window you have the brake lights, of course, right there. And then you have a wiper, the roof spoilers, pretty small, the radio antenna, the roof rails up here, so you can add some extra storage on the roof there. Duster writing, pretty nice, pretty nice. Good. Let me go on the other side, because it's sun here, you can see a little bit better. On the right side, you have the tank right here. You have to open it up from inside, the petrol tank. The windows are really interesting, integrated in the car here. Look how interesting they integrate. It's kind of a unique design. And the other one, you have some kind of a rubber around here, a black rubber. The handles are also unique and interesting. I like them very much. I like the way they make it like that. You can open the door. Also, the quality of the door is not so bad. It's quite good. Let's talk a little bit about the rims. We have 17-inch rims here. That looks really good with the car. And the fact that they are 17, of course, you can put 19, even bigger on it, and it will look much more fancy and interesting. But I think those 17-inch rims, they are perfect for all kind of roads. Normal city drive, also off-roads, because you have a lot of rubber, a lot of comfort. It helps the suspension a lot, so you have much better comfort inside there. You have drums brakes in the back, by the way, no brake discs. They try to save the cost, and also those last longer. Usually you don't have to service them as often as you do with the other one. Ground clearance here pretty huge, and even down there you have pretty big ground clearance. In the front, other story, we have brake discs, ventilated brake discs actually, and yeah, other than that, it's very similar. It looks nice. I mean, it looks really good, those rims, really really good. So that's the exterior, guys. I hope I didn't miss anything, but overall I like the body here, the muscular body on the side. Quite nice, quite nice. Good price, really good price. Yeah, let me open up the front. Let's go to the engine bay. Going here in the front. Where is that? Right here. Wow, we have an automatic liftgate. I didn't expect that. Good, extra, another plus for the car. I like that. And this is the engine, 1.3 liter, 150 horsepower, 250 newton meter. Also around 10 seconds, 0 to 100. The battery, the filter, the fuse box, and yeah, other than that, pretty classic. And it's a pretty silent, actually. It's a silent engine. I drive it on the test drive, you can check it out, and you cannot hear so much noise from the engine. Let me turn off the lights right now from here, so like that, super simple. And let's go in the trunk now. Open up the trunk. Manual lift gate in the trunk, by the way, guys. Don't expect something fancy here. Handles, simple handles. You have this protection for the trunk. I will take it out and we will see how it looks without it. I want to show you first time with this protection on right here. Then you have a flat floor. You have some plastic at the entrance, but you have a flat floor, and this is amazing. I mean, I love that. I love this flat floor right here. You can put the things inside super easy. You have a light, normal bulb light, some storage space here on the left side, some hooks in every corner, if I'm not wrong. Here as well you have some hooks right here. Pretty nice, pretty nice. Now under the floor, I know you're curious, you have a spare tire, a huge spare tire. You can get it as an option in Switzerland. It's 100 francs, around $100. Some storage space on the side, but if you don't want to have it, you can put some repair kit, and you have huge space under the floor here. Pretty impressive. Now I will take out those protection and then we will go. I want to show you forward. We will fold down the seats so you can make a better idea about the space in the back. I just take it out, and now check this out. Huge entrance. You can carry plenty of stuff here because you have a big entrance in the car, so you can put your stuff without any problem right here. Then guys, up here you have a 12 volt port, even in the trunk right here. This is very helpful. I like that very much. I like, to be honest, the way it looks here in the back. It's really awesome. You have a flat floor, you can carry things without any problem. We will fold down also those seats down. I think you have to go there, stretch out there. It's a very long space. I have to go on the side because I don't have any chance to do that from the back because it's a very long trunk. Also you have this headrest adjustable that I have to fold it down, put it like that. Also on the other side, same story. Come on, go down, fold it down. Yeah, it's not a flat floor as you can see right now here, but it's pretty practical. Check this out. It looks quite okay, quite okay. It's not bad at all. What do you think, guys? What do you think about this space? I think it's practical. It's not a flat floor, but still you can carry big many items right here. I'm not sure if you can get forward like that. No, I think this is the maximum. No, yeah, you can get it. No, another few centimeters, so it get almost flat, I should say. Yeah, almost flat, but you can carry many things. And also you can carry here in the front a lot of stuff down here. Also the transmission tunnel there, it's quite small, so you can put even here in the front plenty of stuff. So overall it looks good. Let's go back here, let's see it one more time from the back here. So you can see it's a flat floor, plenty of space, plenty of space here inside. Super practical, super good. Not bad. I like it. I really like what they did with the trunk. Yeah, let me put everything back and then we will go inside and we will talk about other things inside there. Forward guys, here on the doors. So we have a big windows from one pieces. Also on the doors here we have plastic overall. You don't find any soft material on the door here in the back, but you have electric, then you have the handle. You can open up and it looks really good. It feels also good quality. Then you have here the speaker, a big speaker, and some storage space. So overall, yeah, it's a simple door. Going inside, quite big entrance. The entrance is quite okay. And then look at the seats, fabric material seats. They are super simple. I like the blue insertion right there in the stitches. I think it looks nice. On the car, then you have the headrest, adjustable headrest. The quality, it feels quite okay to this fabric. Also you have Isofix, two child seats right here. You have kind of a side support on the side here, but in the middle it's like a sofa, you know, it looks like a sofa. And even here it looks like a sofa, quite clean and straight away. And yeah, we will see how is the comfort on those seats. Also in the middle here you don't have any center armrest, so that's the downside. And also you cannot fold down the middle part to have there, you know, like skis or long items. You have to fold down the other seats from there, so that's a thing to keep in mind. Then behind the front seat you have stuff material. I like that storage space here. Then in the middle here, usually we should expect some USB port, but in this celebration model you don't have any USB, any 12 volt port, nothing, just two cup holders where you can put your things right there. But other than that, pretty simple. Let me go inside. Going inside the car right here, you can go very easily inside. Close the door. As I said before, the noise from outside, it's pretty low, pretty good. And here is the space. This is in my driving position. I think it's a little bit more on the back than in my driving position. This should be a little bit forward to be more realistic, and the space will be more than enough. You can stretch the legs under the seats right there without any problem. So that's something that I love. I mean, look at this, look at my feet all over there, stretch the legs. Now check this out, headroom, huge headroom, no problem. I have handle up here, so I have plenty of headroom. And also the quality on those seats in the back, it's quite good. I wish, although here on my hand, to have some kind of soft material, that would be awesome. But other than that, visibility quite okay. I like this window there, quite okay, not bad. And the seats, even they are fabric, you feel really good here. I mean, you can find a very nice position to stay here. Let me go in the middle. Going in the middle, it's quite easy. I have also this headrest right here. I have huge space on my head, huge. On my legs, I have also plenty of space. Just like that, you can see the seats in the front. Usually you can put the seats more in the front like that, I think, without any problem. Here you have enough space for another person, and even here. And even if I stretch my hand here, check this out, stretch my hand completely, so three people here without any problem. Because they make this like a sofa, straight, almost straight, you can sit here in the middle super good. I mean, wow. I mean, I feel like really like I'm on a sofa home. It's nice. I mean, three people, no problem here, even for long trips. That's really important. Now going forward, we will go in the front. We will talk the things in the front. Also, you have this armrest, adjustable armrest right here, pretty awesome. And we will talk about the dashboard. We will talk about the design in the front and the quality. So yeah, let's go in the front. We talk a little bit about the door in the back, and in the front, it's a little bit different, the door. It's better quality. It's a little bit different design. We have a big window, great visibility outside. Check out the test drive if you want to see more infos about that. But on the upper side you have plastic on all over on the upper side. Here you have soft material in this area, soft material. Here on the armrest you have soft material in this nice blue and white stitches. I like that. So this is perfect like that. Then you have the buttons for the windows, pretty nice electric adjustable windows. Then you have the handle, then you have a handle here again with a little bit of blue insertion, huge storage space here. I like that. And then you have a big speaker here in the front. So pretty nice. The quality is better, it's perfect the way it is. For this price, it's more than enough. Going inside here, guys, we have normal pedals, nothing fancy. Here you have the fuse box, by the way. And then look at the seats. By the way, you have heated seats in the front for you and the passenger, and manual adjustable seats. You have to adjust it manually. But look at the seats, guys, in the front. They are much more beautiful. I mean, the blue insertion, Duster writing, stitches, white, blue, pretty nice signature from Dacia. I like them very much. I like the way they look, and they are super comfy. I drive the car and they are very, very comfortable. I really, really love it. Yeah, great job. What can I say? You have side support. They are bright enough, big enough, long enough. They are great. Now, the dashboard as well, most of it made from plastic, but nice, clean design, unique design. It's quite okay. You have some storage space here, blind spot technology button, the mirrors electrically adjustable from here. You have those vents, kind of unique vents, quite nice. Overall, plastic overall on the dash. Other than that, going inside, visibility around the windows, it is more than good. As I told you before, I make the test drive with the car, and the visibility is more than perfect. You can see one more time that sofa in the back there. And then the armrest here, you already see it, it's pretty helpful. Here some storage space, manual handbrake. Then you have here the setting for the cruise control, for example. You can set it up from here, or you can limit the speed from here. Going forward, you have this two-wheel drive automatic or lock that you can change it from here, pretty simple. Then going forward, you have the gearbox, six-speed gearbox, super easy to use, and I like it very much. I test it and it works really good. Then going forward, this is the key, by the way, very nice light key. You can have it in your pocket without any problem. I really love it. Then you have a cup holder there and a 12 volt port, pretty useful, simple and useful, guys. Going forward, here you have the glove box. Let me show you the glove box. Quite huge, to be honest. Look how deep they are. I stretch all my hand there. It's super deep space, and also you have down here. So Dacia makes some huge deep glove box, and I like them. I really like them the way they are. Also, you have a storage space up here. I think you can see it. Other than that, plastic almost everywhere. Duster writing here on the dash. Nice integration vents right there in the middle. Then you have this. Let me start the engine. This is the start stop engine button. Press the brake. Engine it start. The cockpit, it's simple, analogical cockpit, nothing fancy there. It's just simple. So you have a digital screen in the middle where you can see the consumption and some kind of information, but other than that, it's a simple one. The multimedia system instead, here it's a little bit more complicated. You have an USB port up here, you have this auxiliary in, then you have plus and minus, then you close it, open it. You have a navigation that works really good. You have a very good visibility from the driver point of view right here, so it's great the way they design it. The navigation, yeah, it has a little bit of lag, as you can see, but once you set it, the destination, it's work quite fine, to be honest. So, and it works pretty fast, as you can see right now. It's okay. It's really okay. Then, if you go to home here, you have the radio, then you have the media here, then you can connect your telephone, for example. Then you have the car information, for example, eco driving, give you some tips and stuff like that. You can see even the consumption here on the last kilometers, by the way, the real consumption, the last 250 kilometers, 7.7, not bad at all, to be honest. Eco tips and stuff like that. I tell you, you can get some great consumption over this car. Off-road information here, navigation, you see it before, it's worked really, really good, not bad. And then you have the settings of the car here. You can change the different settings from different things, languages and stuff like that. So it's a simple one, but it's perfect. I mean, it's simple and the way it should be. Going down here, we have some buttons. Pretty helpful buttons. Downhill assist, start stop engine button, eco mode. You can go in eco mode and the car will accelerate slowly. and it will give you kind of a better consumption. Then you have lock and unlock parking sensors, and this one here is a traction control, and here the camera, press the camera once, and as I said before, 360 degrees camera have this Dacia. You can see the reverse camera right here, you can see the front camera, you can see the side camera and the side camera. The resolution is not the best on the market, but it's still wow. I mean, wow, for this price, it's more than what you need, and I love it. Great job, Dacia. I really appreciate that. Going down, something that I like about this car again is this gorgeous climatic system. It's easy to use, it's simple, it looks nice. So you can see also these wheels look good quality. Also you have buttons here for defrosting, fast defrosting and stuff like that, AC on and off. Here you can change where you want to air to go. It's really, really great climatic system in my opinion, and I like it. I like it. I like the way it is. Up here you have a mirror, so as I said, no camera, nothing here in this area, and I like the way it looks. The mirror, stick it to the glass there, look quite fancy. The visibility in the mirror, it's perfect. You can see in the back there, look gorgeous. Up here some light, normal light, microphone, airbag, mirror here, simple. I guess stop it. Great guys, that was the video, that was the review with the Dacia Duster 2. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you get some useful information. I know it's not a new car, but I still want to bring you something valuable to you. I want to remind you that on the market it is an SUV, affordable, that you can buy it as a new with a great price. So yeah, my opinion about this car, it's practical, it's cheap to maintain, the service, it's pretty cheap, you don't have to pay too much money to service the car. You find service for it almost everywhere, and it's practical. You can get off-road with this car, you have a lot of space, you have a lot of comfort, and you can get some great consumption over it. So yeah, that was the video guys. I hope you find it useful. If you find it useful, please like it, share it, subscribe to the channel if you want to see the test drive with this car and the new cars that come on the market. Thank you very much to all of you that watching my video. I really, really appreciate that. Stay safe guys, and I guess I see you soon in the next one. Bye.